magazines and books. I memorize the subway map too. It's one block north to Macy's and two to Brothers Brooks. Manhattan, I prepare for you. You certainly are different from what they have back home, where nothing's over three stories high, and no one's in a hurry or wants to roam. But I do, though they wonder why. They said I would soon be good and lonely. They said I would sing the homesick blues. To do with as I choose. Burn the bridge, bet the store, baby's coming home no more. Not for the
Millie! forgotten.
My purse is gone.
And?
My hat, my scarf, my shoe.
They stole your shoe?
While I was wearing it. 10 minutes in this town and I already have my New York Horror Story.
Honey, you're my New York Horror Story.
But it's every penny I have.
Hey, I feel for you. I'll cross the street next time I see you, but I feel for you. Girls like you arrive here every day, so full of dreams, you may as well be sleepwalking. Well, now you're awake. Why not ask yourself, do I belong here? Because New York is great enough, but the cost of living is high. And I ain't talking cash. And I can't help thinking that if I were in your shoe, I'd make a beeline straight back to Cucuck or Gopherville or...
Salina, Kansas. And who are you? The unwelcome wagon?
Let me get this straight. You knock me flat on my back and make me wait a bit with a sweet little bomb. But still now, I took a minute to give you some sound advice. My good deed for the decade.
If this is your good deed, I'd hate to see a bad one, because you're really not helping.
I'm trying to by telling you the way it is. Look, you got a place to stay?
No, but...
Any friends or family nearby?
No, but...
And you don't have a job?
No, but...
No buts. You ain't got nothing. Listen, I said I was doing you a good deed.
The Hotel Priscilla?
A rooming house for actresses. They're used to girls that can't pay. Check yourself in, get a good night's sleep, then first thing tomorrow, wire home for train fare. Your folks will be only 2 bath descendants. And you may not believe me now, but once you return to, Kansas, was it? You'll say to yourself, why had my big adventure? But it sure is good to be back in my own bed.
Calloused hands, broken heart, dreams that die before you start. I ain't got nothing. So, I ain't got nothing to lose! Who needs a hat? Who needs a purse? And who needs you, Mr. Whoever you are? Cause I'm a pioneer woman, pal!
Creepy. mostly orphans, whose sudden disappearance often goes unnoticed.
Sad.
We are all one in the world. None of you need to worry, Lord, with you and your big, warm families. No, you got to read this!
It's a telegram for you, Ethel. Baby random or no.
Routine emergency on her home. Aries. Gloria. Rita. Cora. Lucille. Mary. Mary Donna. Where is she?
Coming to pavement.
With her head. Poor kid.
Who knew an office job was harder to land than a part of the show?
She's taking the early bird every day this week, but no more of this show for it.
And the rest of you? Well, I still recall how a dead unknown Heron Hayes rolled.
That's our few girls.
Don't fuss, Mirzy. We'll make you proud.
Yeah, if we're not Shanghai to Hong Kong.
What is it, Ethel? Not bad news.
Good night. It's my uncle.
Dear Miss Ethel Pete. Hotel for Sarah. Regret to inform you. Stop. Great Uncle Shire's Carey. Stop. In freak trashing accident. Stop. What a way to go. Well, my condolences to your family.
My parents died when I was just a baby.
I had no idea. Cousins, aunts, anyone to keep tab on you.
Just me and my uncle died. The farm in the middle of nowhere.
Sad to be alone in the world. But step into my office and enjoy a soothing cup of green tea. One of the mysteries of the Orient. By the time you finish, you'll be calm and quiet and ready for a very long nap.
Hello? Buddha? Butterfly here. I got one for you. The Southern Belle your customers will want to ring. $400, cash only.
What's there to think about? This offer good for a limited time only, so order now.
Attaboy, Buddha.
Mercy!
Coming, dear.
Hello? It's me. It's Millie.
Mirzy? Authorized personnel only. Now am I right?
I don't have it yet.
We said today at noon.
But I finally found a job that meets all of my requirements. And they said they'd call by... I bet it's them.
Hello, Hotel Becerra. How am I helping you? What's that? Mary Dermot? Job? Oh, I see. Ah, yes. I need to write it to get her message. Bye.
You didn't get it. I'm going to tell Mary to pack your things or you'll find her out on the street
with Mirzy. This is Mirz to you.
The other girls call you Mirzy.
The other girls are paid in full. I give you 1 week on credit and type right out.
Excuse me, I'd like to inquire after the room for rent.
What are you, listening at the door? Even an ambulance chaser waits for a siren.
The sign says vacancy.
Don't believe everything you read.
May I please see the concierge?
I don't know what that is, but I know this hotel has me caught.
Heavens!
Trust me, you don't want to stay here. The manager's mean, the rooms are hot, the water's always cold.
This is for me, this is for joy for me. I'm hungry for this taste, heaven knows when. Year after year, a secret yet. All my cares, all my desires, every waking moment with my heart apart.
Yeah, well, there's only one room available and it's mine. So, unless you want a roommate. For a night or two, that is. It's a single bed, so you take the floor.
Perfect!
Give me the meat, without the gravy. I'll take the oysters, sans the pearls. Pinching pennies, clipping coupons. See a brand new run brown. Let me brown bag all my lunches. Try my hand at canteen.
Rock to what happened.
You mean 1208?
Ecto, please, just check out.
She only just checked in.
Ecto joined an all-girl repertory company for their Mongolian cheer.
She just chewed my ear off about 2 hours ago about her non-existing career.
That's showbiz! Now, if you'll grant Mr. Doherty, I mean Miss Doherty, Meryl's and Mary, always some for you. Mary has such a big, warm family. Do you have such a big, warm family, Miss Doherty?
I'm an orphan.
Are you? Sad to be alone in the world. 12th floor, dear.
Love.
Of aptitude and enthusiasm can take a girl from nowhere straight to the top. So let's do this the American way. Bolt the door, take off your things,
let's have a taste.
Excuse me?
Take a letter to a Mr. John of Hudson's for wax. You'll find an invoice in the file for the address. Dear Mr. Hudson, Corp, my eyes are fully open to my awful situation, so I'm writing you a letter to demand an explanation. When the Floax that we bought from you arrived here Monday morning, we discovered upon usage that the fume should have a warning. Since the only possibility is that your wax is rancid, I request a full refund of all the money we advanced. And convince me you've improved the Floax better, we will take our business elsewhere. So, I hope you solve this match. How's my speed, Miss Delmount?
A little slow, perhaps.
Enclosed, you'll find a small container of the stuff I talk about. Just carefully unravel it and take a whiff and put it down. I'm sure you wouldn't want me to alert the daily papers with words about how this was affected by the papers. which one I choose to write to you. A confidential letter with a strong recommendation that you make your flow expert. I should hope it won't require us to have it before we leave. And if it does, you may expect to be able to see the information great. Now, read that back to me, please.
Certainly. Dear Mr. Hudson.
Colon.
My eyes are fully open to my awful situation, so I'm writing you a letter to demand an explanation. The Florex that we bought from you arrived Monday morning, and we discovered a conflict which that was due to have a warning. So the only possibility is that your watch is rented, request before you pay all the money we intend.
Nice!
And unless we can convince the other to move the Florex battle, we will take our business elsewhere, so I can use all this matter.
Not happy! If I could be so lucky as to have a substantial, this place as up to date as your short skirt and cloth floor, I wouldn't have to worry about how soured all this planking, and could concentrate on generating profits right for begging. That is why I'm testing you with this outrageous correspondence, which I don't intend to actually mail to the respondents. So, if you can make sense of my unintelligible pattern, then the joys of my heart are
unfortunately can't make a surgeon.
All right, if you insist. Heavens!
Mrs. Maisie!
Who?
Mrs. Maisie!
Sad to be all around in the world.
Mrs. Pierce! What about her?
Oh, my mom!
My child! No, not now. She came home in before that. I think I'm more than now, but I'm not sure.
You gentlemen clearly have pressing matters to discuss, so I'll leave you to it. And thank you. I so appreciate the rose.
Must I do everything myself? But both take care of your brother, and I'll take care of Miss Dorothy.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Mears.
Carey,
and some for you.
Mommy, I've saved mushrooms and a pizzeria.
A California apple.
And a California orphan. Sad to be all alone in the world. But don't worry, Mac. Take a bite.
An apple a day.
Well, hello. What new? You an actress? I'm an actress. But we couldn't be more different, so we'll never be up the same part. Which is a good thing, don't you think?
Where's Deborah? My stage name, anyway. The real one's the brown skin. But imagine that one up on marquee.
Be sure to goodbye.
Now, where were we? Ah, yes.
It smells very ripe.
That'd be kind of juicy. Go on, have a taste.
I'll say, where'd you get that? I'm starved.
I'll share it with you.
Gee, thanks!
Alice! Remember that delivery boy you had your eye on? Well, any minute now, that Iceman coming.
Iceman?
Idiot! Miss Dorothy, I did it! Gloria Ruth Ellis!
You're looking at the future, Mrs. Trevor Braden. He advanced me my first paycheck. So we're all painting the town red tonight to celebrate. On me. To thank each and every one of you.
Thank us.
For what?
The purse, the hat, the dress. Well, in a minute.
What about the rent?
2 weeks' worth.
I take that.
And I'll take that.
Kitchen crumbs.
Beat it!
All aboard, darling!
What's he going on now?
I think he's here.
Well, I think I'm thirsty.
So come on, girls. Don't be that noisy.
I'm all set by one.
one.
All of the theater heading back to the hotel?
No!
Like the end of the apple, I have my heart set on tasting the forbidden fruit. You first-timer, I enjoy a festive sip of champagne, but spirits, never.
Me neither. The line is dry as a bone.
Ain't no booze in this country.
I've never even played a drunk scene.
Gloria.
My grandmother's fruitcake is a hell of a kick to me.
That settles it. I don't care if it's an undercover copper. We stop and ask the next person we see. Make that the next person.
Kansas?
Millie, you know this man?
It's a short story.
Surprise ending. What are you doing here? We're gonna make a U-turn.
Good idea!
Come on, girls.
Wait a minute. He looks like he knows where to go to get a drink around here.
Well, it just so happens you're staring at the hottest speaker in town. But once you cream toast and hook the right clothespin, that juice hole ain't never gonna open.
Excuse me, but I'm from California. I don't speak New York
yet. He says we're inches away from quenching our thirst, but they won't let us in.
Listen to you. You come a long way.
A lot can happen in 7 days. Just read the Bible.
Well, the Bible won't help you here. You have to be escorted by a member.
Well?
What are you nuts? I got a girl waiting in there for me.
Think of it as next decade's good deed.
Please!
All right. With the moment we're in, you're on your own.
Thank you.
where I'm from, the only person you find behind bars is the town drunk.
It's no different here. It's just four of us.
How long do you think they'll keep us?
Overnight. Unless you've got a hairpin. I have a knack for breaking and entering.
Misspent youth?
18 years on Long Island. If that ain't misspent, I don't know what is.
Well, you can dance it.
You stuck me in the sun. These are as wide as an ocean.
You think the East River's wide? Kansas may as well be the moon, and I fell from it.
You landed on your feet.
I landed in jail. I hope you're serious about that hairpin. I'm gonna be at work in a few hours.
What do you do?
Sign off. For now. You?
Done. When I watch your show, I'm an usher for a night. When the Yankees play at home, it's popcorn, peanuts, Cracker Jacks. And when the open seats are gone, the circle line is always in need of a knowledgeable guide.
And you make a living?
I make a life. Oh, it sure beats sitting at a desk for 8 hours, writing over the press of steel.
Steel?
My old job, steel equipment for offices.
Oh, paperclips like.
Yep, paperclips like.
I've never piped you for a paperclip man. Bootleg gin, maybe, or ladies' lingerie.
I thought you piped me for a jerk.
I did. But I still think you deserve better than paperclips.
So do you.
How do you like that? You got something in common?
Can I ask you a personal question? 7395-16.
What?
Your name.
No, I don't know.
Jimmy Smith.
Tell it to the judge.
Minister, but I do not. The right and easy is the first and easiest.
on to the office.
A quick of a job.
I'm new on the job, so I doubt they'll overlook my being late.
Well, they know it's good for them. I'm lucky to have you knowing them out.
Thank you. And may I say, Jimmy Smith, the Circle Line is lucky to have you. You're not so hot with new arrivals, but underneath it all, I've got a hunch for a really great guy.
Say, you're a Yankees fan?
Need help with Cracker Jack?
Actually, I've got tickets to tonight's doubleheader. In fact, why not play hooky, and we'll make a day of it.
No can do. You don't know my fiancé.
Fiancé?
Boss and fiancé. I'm going to marry him.
Wow. Love at first sight?
Not for the moderns. She takes charge of her destiny. No more waiting at Corp for my ship to come in. I went out and found him.
So, I guess the ballgame's out.
Why? Oh. You weren't thinking we go at us, like on a game.
Us? No, no, no. Of course not. Matter of fact, I have a third ticket. I was just about to suggest you invite your friend along, you know. California?
Miss Dorothy? Why? I gotta go.
Till tonight, Candace?
Till tonight, Long Island.
Watering holes he frequents from here to New Jersey.
It's true. Mr. Smith has friends.
Stand by.
What are you talking about? Where are you going?
Oh, no place special. Just the glamorous penthouse of Muzzy Van Hoss here.
Back from a world tour. And somehow, Jimmy wrangled an invite to her welcome home party.
Speaking of which, come on, Millie.
Don't wait up, ladies. These showbiz parties go to all hours.
Showbiz parties!
Lest you worry, we'll have the finest of chaperones.
We know, we know.
Muzzy!
Thank you.
father used to be the gardener in the Long Island Man.
I still say Jim is the only one who could turn a hedge like his daddy used to do.
Well, no, Emma, let's go to the ground, can I present to you? Well, I'll see them ask me.
What an honor, Mrs.
Muzzy, Millie.
Muzzy.
Muzzy!
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 I've been auditioning for David Velasco quite early, so I'm going tonight.
Muzzy!
Few people and
Lucky enough to see.
Are you sitting on his lap?
No.
Has he kissed you?
No.
Does he have a pet name for you?
Yes!
What?
John.
John! It's not very romantic.
But it's modern. He calls me John because I'm so efficient. Johnny on the spot. I'll let you in on a little secret. This morning, he came this close to popping the question.
He did?
John,
he said,
don't ever leave Sincere Trust Insurance Company.
Sweet. Maybe you could work it into the vows.
Another crack. Every time I mention Mr. Gray.
Can I ask you a favor? A really big one, and I know it would be hard for you. Can you not talk about your friend for once?
Why not?
Because I'm sick of hearing about it. You want to marry a man who thinks of you as typewriter on legs? Be my guest.
Thank you, I will. The new woman chooses reason over romance any day of the week, and I'm a new woman.
So why set your sights on the world's oldest profession?
If I were you, I'd keep my trap shut about other people's professions.
Mister, I used to be in paperclips.
Well, maybe we shouldn't speak at all. Maybe our nightly excursions are taking too much space on my dance card.
What do I care? Soon enough, all of my time will be consumed by my boss/fiancé, Mr. Trevor Graydon III.
I'm warning you, Millie. I've had enough to hear with you and Graydon.
Well, then I don't know what to tell you, because I'm going to be his wife. What will you be, butterfly boy, flower, flower, flower?
What's the problem with that?
I'm merely suggesting that you grow up, skirt chaser.
Gold digger.
Womanizer.
Jezebel.
Casanova.
Thank you. Sincerely appreciated. Please accept our insincerest apology. Yours insincerely.
I'm sorry, Miss Flannery.
If you are not, you will be. I'm docking you a dollar.
A dollar?
Insincere trust.
Make it two.
Jimmy, leave me alone.
Personal love? Now all company time.
Not another dollar.
Sincere trust.
Jimmy, we have nothing more to say to each other.
Still not. I didn't ask him to call.
I don't want him to call. I never want to see Jimmy Smith again.
Good. Forget the boys, Dillmount. Get yourself a canary.
No canary in a cage for me. This canary's ready to fly free.
Really go after him.
Oh, Mr. G!
Who?
You. Do you have a mo?
A what?
A moment. I would love to get a man's opinion on Rudolph Valentino.
Okay.
I mean, in the Chic. He takes Agnes airs by brute force. And she enjoys it. She enjoys it a lot. So, Mr. Graham, what is your opinion on brute force?
I'm not for it.
Not for it at all.
That is not what women really want today.
Give them a young man they can trust. Tom Sawyer, at 12.
I never read Tom Sawyer. Was he sexy?
12.
Well, you got it, you got it.
I got it!
Billy,
yeah.
Really, we have to talk about last night.
In case you didn't get the message by my slamming the phone in your ear, let's forget last night ever happened.
You can't be serious.
I am serious. I never want to see you again.
But why?
Don't act like you have no idea.
I don't know what I did, Billy.
Just get out of here!
Fine, I'm sorry.
Millie, I hate to bother you at the office.
More research on how the other half lives?
Whack,
Jack. Got tasted by myself last night.
I must see the party you mean? Was it in heaven? When you house the night we plunged into the depths of Hades?
Funny thing about remorse.
Oh, Millie, I feel so dirty. He had this peculiar grin on his face as he went to shake my hand. Only it wasn't my hand he went to shake. He
pounced.
I couldn't breathe.
He takes your breath away.
I felt
in the pit of your stomach.
My knees buckled.
No wonder you couldn't stop him. As far as you knew, I was going to marry my boss.
You mean you're not?
Oh, I most certainly am. Miss Dorothy, promise me no man will ever come between us.
As if anyone could take the place of my best friend. But what does this have to do with my audition for David Bosco?
Oh, right! That was this morning! How'd it go?
Fine. Until he pounced.
Him too? Boy, you really deserve it.
Do I look like the sort of girl who would allow him to take liberties?
You look helpless. Which is better, as far as men are concerned. They think they can get away with it. Well, take a page out of my book, Miss Dorothy. Calico! Higher heels, shorter skirts, and you're not gonna like this. Cut your hair!
Cut my hair?
No more little girl lost in the lion's den. What I'm offering you is the fashion equivalent to a whip and a chair. Tame the beast. No time like the present, Miss Dorothy.
John, be a good old scout ring on my handball court. Reserve a court for 6:15, will you?
Yes, sir.
Gotta work with a good sweat. Edgy in the gut, tight in the...
Telling you truly.
Did you two meet? Mr. Graydon, this is my friend, Miss Dorothy Brown, from the Priscilla Hotel. We're spending my lunch hour at the Mad Cow Beauty Spot. Miss Dorothy's gonna have her hair smartly bobbed.
Bobbed! With your beauty.
Mr. Graydon, he hit you.
I bet you can make the moon and stars behave.
Miss Dorothy's an actress, so I just thought the way theater is today, so rot.
You wouldn't rob some lucky stiff of playing with those adorable curls now, would you?
I only thought if she cut her hair.
Chuck it, John! Just chuck it!
Mr. Green calls me John, see, because I'm so efficient.
Miss Dorothy, I'm going to take you to dinner and try to talk to you. I'm doing that part such a disservice. May I take the liberty of asking you to dine?
You may.
And afterwards, a bit of vaudeville the hippodrome. That is, if their comics are not on, their humor can get altogether too wrinkled for Millie's ear.
Perfect. Millie, I think I'll keep my curls, at least until tonight. Instead, I'm going to find a suitable frock for this evening.
Twill be gilding the lily.
Hush, Mr. Graydon.
Trevor.
Till tonight?
7:15.
Sharp.
That Miss Dorothy, great Scott, that Miss Dorothy! Pretty as peach and skin to beat the band!
Perfect.
What a dandy little bundle from Feldacuddle.
Dandy.
Say, imagine all that sweet softness in your arms. Yes? Well, make dinner reservations at the plaza. The candle to brew. Quiet corner table for two. I think Miss Dorothy's in the plaza, don't you? And John, flowers.
There's flowers around the corner from the hotel. I'll order from them.
That's using the old bean. Roses. Hey, 2 dozen.
2 dozen.
Long stem.
Long stem.
Oh, plump.
On the fat side.
Millie, out here.
For God's sake, Jimmy, what are you doing?
How else can I get to you? Old Doubles has every door barricaded. She says you never want to see me again.
That's what I told her.
Take it back. Or I'll jump, Jimmy!
I am in no mood for this. It has been a rough day.
Can I help?
I don't know. You need to stand up. I'm quitting my job. Mr. Graydon isn't available. He's lost his heart. Talk about your tangled web. He's fallen for a friend of ours.
Miss Dorothy? Well, I'll be...
Bitter? No, Jimmy. Don't blame her. I don't. I really don't. Mr. Gray neither. Love swamped them. We're too young to live away from hate.
I agree. So let's kiss and make up. Or at least make up. Maybe our kissing wasn't such a good idea after all.
Or maybe you just prefer kissing Miss Dorothy.
What are you talking about?
Don't deny it, Jimmy. I was a little giddy from champagne, but I saw you leaving her room.
What did you think we were doing?
Gee, I can't imagine. Not that I need to. She told me everything.
Then you got your wires crossed. Yes, I went to her room last night. I needed to talk to somebody.
An intimate conversation from the looks of it.
As a matter of fact, it was. I've been so confused, really so mixed up. Ever since you tripped me, life's been so topsy-turvy. Like not, for instance. What am I doing on the window ledge, hundreds of feet in the air?
Good question! Can you answer it inside? Jimmy, you're making me nervous.
No thanks. I like the view. The world looks so different from up here, Miller.
Better or worse?
You tell me.
It's just the same skyline I see every day.
We're talking 20 stories beneath us. Dozens of buses, hundreds of cabs, thousands of people way down below, wandering to and fro. Tireless people, no time to move, bound in the avenues and walks on their horns, racing fast. What a cast, millions of people, make any two, they could be just like you. destiny's guiding hand. Fortune or fate is grand. The way you make me feel.
Thank you. Mrs. Maisie.
Now what, Chingho?
No, Major Leso, I don't know that surgeon.
Oh, Sinyana. Jok, we home for?
Lay down me back, no Chinghai ma.
Leave us, I can't you, Lala. You're the sir, you're the king. Well, then, you're the gangala.
Lay down me back, no Chinghai ma.
Spare me the family view. It boils down to this. Who's it gonna be, boys?
Miss Dorothy?
Or Mama?
Everything seems lovely when you start to roam.
The birds will sing in the day that you stray, but wait until you are farther away.
Things won't be so lovely when you're people.
both came up short.
True. Nothing to find out. Prices on the menu. Overshade.
This is not how I intended this evening to end.
You sure about that?
What's that supposed to mean?
You want to see a show?
I said I would ask Muzzy to front this to toe.
She's busy. It's not like you're gonna have to pay her back.
There'll be macaroni in my room until my next paycheck.
And you. Never mind.
What? Go on.
Mrs. Scott.
Where's the soy sauce?
I'll stick with vinegar. My grandmother swears it'll clean anything.
Granny dear, mother mine.
Wild.
Little Millie,
this marriage you've got in mind? Love has everything to do with it. You're starting my number. Follow your heart. A simple choice, nothing more. This or that.
Oh, hello, John. More coffee.
Strong coffee.
not strong enough. Could not never be strong enough.
Could not never? Double negative.
Oh, Mr. Green, what's happened to you?
She stood me up.
Miss Dorothy stood you up. How very strange.
Millie, you didn't leave.
I started to.
Stay!
Alex, lane later. Go on, Mr. Green.
I went to the hotel, Priscilla, to call on Miss Dorothy and the lady at the front desk.
Mrs. Mears.
Said that she had checked out. No, not. No, forwarding address. Jerry, where is she?
I don't know.
Something's very wrong.
You suspect that place, sir?
Well, she wouldn't check out without telling anybody.
And we'll be as in. And another girl when I first moved in. Both of them were here one day and gone the next. Without a word to anyone except for Mrs. Mears.
What do the young ladies have in common? Were they possessions?
Gosh, no. Ethel Peaston now died. And what's her name is flat broke. And an orphan, poor thing. Shad! She'll be all alone in the world.
How's that?
Mrs. Mears is always saying that.
Mrs. Mears again.
You don't think.
I do.
You don't mean
white slavery! Cruel butchery. If a young girl is all alone in the world and she checks out, who's to question her fate?
But Miss Dorothy isn't all alone in the world.
Sir.
She's got us.
Where did you last see her? At the Priscilla?
I knocked on the door when I got home from work, but there was no answer. I figured she was napping.
Kidnapping, I say.
Not if I can help it. I'm calling the police.
Damn fool. Anything that might arouse Mrs. Mears' suspicion committed attitude.
He's right. What we need is a temporary orphan. Someone who's willing to put herself in harm's way.
I get it. Take the bait, do a Sleeping Beauty, then we dismiss Dorothy.
Bingo. I do it myself, but she knows me.
And she's unlikely to forget the cane I raised when she told me Miss Dorothy was gone.
Graydon, I don't think either of us passes a new girl in town.
But I know someone who would.
Oh!
Sad! You're all in the world!
adventurous home for orphan children.
Did you walk?
Now, if you register.
Zazu, Rosie,
Schmetman. It's Swedish.
Daddy, I think you finish.
Now, before I show you to your room, why don't we get acquainted over a freshly cup of brewed green tea?
Oh, I'm just mad at the green tea.
Hello, Buddha Butterfly here. I got one for you. Price is still at $2.70. $2.50. A little long in the tooth, but in a dark corner on the late, late shift at Big Mary's Tart Shop in Oshkosh.
You coming?
Maybe it's $1.50.
Orphans, every one of them, who no one ever misses when they disappear.
Capri-tree.
But then again, I don't have to tell you. You'll have lots of time to hear their stories on those summer nights in Hong Kong.
Bring that back to me, please!
In Hong Kong, I don't know about Hong Kong, but I do recall that those who have been in there took out a night until today, or else it's not like town, and sometimes groups everyone know. No one ever misses when they disappear from home. But I don't have to tell me, you'll have lots of time to hear the stories as you get to know them on those summer nights in Hong Kong.
Boss after all. Who cares? I
found myself in another one.